what scientists refer to when they talk about an experimental system is a set of experiments done on a biological system that allows them to get to access to certain questions for which there are no answers.
So when you're thinking about what model system to use, so this is something that is not something that is always very much in our control, right? So it might be that you're in a specific type of lab that has a very specific type of expertise. And, you know, I think in science in general, when you're thinking about the long term of your career, I do think it's really important to consider, you know, which model organisms or model systems are really, really the most powerful for answering the questions that you're after. But when you're within a specific type of lab and you're sort of limited by resources or whatever it may be, there may not be much choice that you have. So, you know, one thing that's really important to do is to try and think of, you know, what types of questions or what aspect of the question that you're asking are you poised to answer using the system that you're using. So that would be sort of the other side of that coin, is not just how do you pick a model system, but, you know, what is the best use of the model system that you're after? So within the big scientific question that you're asking.
What is important for the starting graduate student is to understand why that lab chose that system. What are the strengths and the weaknesses of that system in addressing the different questions, because that's gonna create a framework of what type of questions you wanna go after, depending on the strength of the system. The system is gonna limit how far you can go with a given question. So the way to understand the limits of the system, you can start by first understanding what the history of the system is. Why did people set up that system in the first place? What were the questions that they felt could be best addressed with that system?
There may be one system that has, you know, really, really good for, you know, forward genetics, you know, or another model system that's really, really good for reverse genetics, and some that might be particularly suited to specific types of imaging. And so you may say that, you know, in this organism, so in our case, we're studying a green algae, and in this case, we can do some really, really wonderful forward genetics and biochemistry and imaging in the flagella that we're studying. And so what we want to do is really go after the types of experiments that we are uniquely poised to answer in this model systems.
So how you define the question is very much tied with the answer that you're gonna get, but also with the system that you're using.
The examples are, we studied secretion in dog pancreas because pancreatic cells, they're dedicated tissue to secrete all your hormones and everything else that you need for your body. So they do secretion 100 times more than your stomach or your nerve or anybody else. So if you take a pancreatic cell, they're chock through the machinery to do secretion, and therefore if you understand secretion, that's a good place to study it. Another example is, how are we going to find out how cells, what are the protein structures at the ends of chromosomes? Well, humans have 46 chromosomes, that's 92 ends, but this little organism called Tetrahymena shatters its chromosomes into 2,000 pieces, so it's got 4,000 ends. So if you want to study the proteins that are at the ends of chromosomes, you study in Tetrahymena because that's a great place to study it.
What makes biology so exciting today is that the choice of organisms now is getting larger and larger. I mean, all the way to humans. I mean, the things that information we can get out of even human beings today is, you know, incredible and much more advanced than, you know, earlier decades ago. So, I mean, we're in a really exciting time in biology where, again, we're the menu of choices of what we can study and how we can study it has opened up a whole variety of questions, you know, obviously that weren't possible to address, you know, when I was a graduate student. But it still requires that wise choice of really carefully thinking about choices right at the onset of the project.